Which is still triple R.
It is my turn. Well, Rudy just bought something. Okay, so this is the first stock round of 1830.
It's your turn to buy, you know.
1830 is a game about railroad building and stock manipulation, although it is more about the latter than the former. The goal is to amass the most money. The game ends when either a player goes bankrupt or the bank itself runs out of money. There will be stock manipulation, the building of railroads via train track tiles, the creation and management of railroad companies, and a lot of backhanded dealing.
It's your turn to buy, you know.
I am buying a share of New York, New Haven, Hartford, so that floats.
67.
So that's another 67. Thank you. So this is a very complex train game. Actually, it's a stock game disguised as a train game, so don't believe the lies.
In the stock round, players will have a chance to sell any number of railroad shares, buy one share of a railroad, and then sell a number of shares again. The price of a share is determined by the par value, which is set upon the purchase of a president's share. In this case, the value of a single share is set at $82. The price of a share can fluctuate based on the actions of the players.
Could you give me $3 back? Dr. Potato is the banker. We have several people here.
Do you
use
a,
use an alias or a name? I don't care which.
1, 2, 3, 4, 20, 34.
Other person, do you want to be your alias or your name?
Oh, he
just
bought it.
I'm buying 1, 2. What?
Interview.
Oh, hi.
Who are you? Hi, who are you?
James.
James? Yes. Okay, you're James. Hi, James. What do you think? So you played this game before.
No.
What is your evil strategy? Okay.
Your turn?
Oh, you really are James?
Yeah.
Oh, I should have known that.
Okay. Why are you doing like this?
That's my middle name.
Oh, my mind.
Alright, so alright, so you bought some. Oh, can you pass me the station markers?
Because I had just stopped for the beginning.
That completely changed.
Oh, this is
strategy.
James!
I can buy my strategy is gone.
If you buy this, you float my company.
Oh, yeah.
Don't. Do not.
There's only three out, right?
Yeah, buy Canada.
Four.
Canada.
Four.
If you buy it, it floats. That's fine.
If six shares of a company are bought between all the players, that company floats and is able to operate during the next operating round. The company gains money equal to 6 times its par value. It gains train markers for placement on the main board, and then at the start of the operating round will be able to lay track and run trains.
That's fine.
So we can see there's a lot of excitement here. We're trying to argue over buying companies.
You buy one at folks.
And somehow this game's a lot more lively than I expected it to be.
A lot more lively than it was. Bankrupt.
Rudy's here again. What do you think of this game so far? Or what do you think of the game in general?
Well, it seems like it's going to be more fun this time than it was last time.
Well, last time you were distracted the entire time.
Yep.
Okay.
I was trying to roll this time.
Okay.
Wait, don't you need money about trains?
Yep. Anyways.
That company gets money.
Oh, speaking of which, that company needs money. Yeah. Alright, so this cock round's getting pretty hectic, so I'll do post-game. Well, okay, so we had the first few operating rounds, nothing much has happened. Has anything happened?
No, but I suspect you're going to try and screw me with the presidency of this company that seems to have built a station in the middle of nowhere.
I don't know what you're talking about.
There are 1 to 3 operating rounds between each stock round, depending on the phase of the game. In the operating round, companies rather than players will go. The companies will take their turns in order of highest value company to lowest value company. The first thing a company does when they just floated is to place their home station marker on their starting station space. Then the company will lay track, place additional station markers, run trains, generate revenue, and buy new trains. Play continues like this for all companies until the operating round or rounds has finished, and then another stock round begins.
Okay, so there's this company I am president of, and the stock in it are in its kind of trapped. Now there's two ways I could really go with it. One, wait for a phase change and then expand to it, or two, dump it on Dr. Potato. And Rudy? What has anything notable gone on that you've noticed other than not doing anything?
The only thing that's gone on is apparently screwed myself over by screwing you over.
Okay, so everybody has a private company.
You're also doing better than me.
Everybody has a private company but me. That is, they have a base revenue generator. I have none, but I think I have the most money of anybody in the game right now.
Could be.
Could be. So, yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. We will see how this goes.
Trains must be bought in order of lowest cost train to highest cost train. When a new type of train has been bought, a phase change occurs. When a Type 4 train is bought, all of the Type 2 trains are gone from the game, causing a lot of panic and shift in purchases, because companies must buy a train if they can run a train and have no trains left. This can lead to forced purchases and possible bankruptcy of the players.
His money.
Hey, so I have a big pile of money. And look at all of these tiles. Some of them are green, some of them are yellow, some of them are run around. How's everybody doing? Okay. Okay, so everybody hates me right now. We generally established that. Except Brendan. Brendan shouldn't hate me.
No. Okay. We each go to a separate room and talk about how we're doing right now.
So,
that army totally f***ed me over.
They did that for the fucking 11th period.
What's going on?
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. Shut up, we're not. Or whatever.
No, oh. Not yet. This is what's operating? It's you, right?
It's PNR. PNR.
I thought, did you finish?
No,
PNR, he did. PNR finished what did already.
No, PNR. I didn't go anywhere.
Yeah, you did. You bought your trains.
Oh.
Wait, did you ship anything?
He can.
He can.
Oh, he just did.
Yeah. Lay down. Shit.
Yeah. So, what's been happening in this first half of the game, really?
Rapist.
Madness.
Train rapist.
Trains. Trains.
Yeah.
Yep. And I'd say that's a fair assessment. Basically, a company grew and grew and grew, and then I dumped it on a friend. Not a friend really anymore, I guess. And dumping a company means I devalued it quite terribly, and I started a new one. So, yeah, that's about it for right now. And
how the crap did I get last?
You
did by one.
They got last.
Out of the people.
So we had two people drop out for the last bit of this game, the last long bit of this game.
Yeah.
Person named Dr. Potato One, who I will bleep out any attempts at saying his name.
Because you picked the worst company in the beginning.
To my surprise, I did not expect
it. And then you bought Yuri to like...
That Yuri screwed me over.
Yeah.
Screwed me over.
I actually came out pretty bad compared to... I was, what, number three?
You were third.
Third out of seven. Yeah. So it was Dr. Potato, Chris?
Yes.
Okay. Me, Trynant,
That guy,
Rudy, and then the two people who dropped out. So, final thoughts on the game so far.
Megusa.
I don't know what that means.
I turned NNH around.
Okay. Brendan, too long?
A little bit.
Okay.
But I actually got to play the game.
Halfway through. The game.
I played the game halfway through.
Rudy?
I kind of got to play the game halfway into it.
Oh yeah, two companies, not at all. Yeah.
It was interesting that in the other game that I played, nobody sold stocks ever. And in this game, selling stocks is pretty serious. Yeah.
That when that four train, no, when that six train hit, man, things changed a whole bunch.
I said,
well, no, everyone says
I said
so
no, I know, I said PNR you. So I saw majority of that and started the B&O company.
Yep.
And then so, everyone played musical chairs.
Yeah, we played musical companies.
I stuck with Canada.
You stuck with Canada, and it kind of did stuff for you.
And then halfway through the game, what was taken? We said insider trading. Erie needs to go to him. He still lost, though. So.
Yeah. And then there was this whole bit where I took Erie under his nose, and then he got it back, but still, that was funny. And then I think we had mostly a fair game with a few rules screw ups, but what can you expect from the learning game of a game of this caliber, you know? Was the game fun for anybody?
Yes.
Okay.
I got to screw someone over with that. Put that right there.
Yes. Okay. I'm not going to do too much more because, unfortunately, this game did take much longer than I anticipated. So, yep, good night.